In this video, we'll take a look at Cohen's Kappa, a performance metric for a classification model. We'll show what it measures, how it compares to overall accuracy, and how it can sometimes mislead you. Let's take a look at an example workflow that predicts the credit worthiness of credit customers with the decision tree algorithm. The scorer node reports the performance of the classification model in its interactive view. In this overall accuracy statistics table, we find the overall accuracy, overall error, Cohen's Kappa, and other metrics. But why do we need both overall accuracy and Cohen's Kappa? When the target class is highly unbalanced, the overall accuracy is biased. For example, when customers with a good credit rating represent 90% of the data, and the customer with a bad rating only make up the remaining 10%. A classification model that predicts the rating of all customers as good would reach an overall accuracy as high as 90%. Cohen's Kappa tries to correct this bias by taking into account the a priori distribution of the target classes. Cohen's Kappa is calculated with this formula. The numerator is the difference between the overall accuracy of the model, P0, and the overall accuracy that could be reached by a random guess, PE. The denominator is the maximum value of this difference as given by a perfect model with an overall accuracy of 100%. To calculate the overall accuracy for our random guess, PE, we make the strong assumption that the model predictions are not affected by the a priori distribution of the target class. Notice though, that this assumption is often violated when working with unbalanced data, since the classification model tends to predict the majority class in case of uncertainty. We can calculate Cohen's Kappa based on the confusion matrix. We have pre-calculated the row and column totals of the confusion matrix. Here in the top row total value, we see the a priori probability of the class bad, 10% in our case. In the left column total value, we see for how many customers the model predicted the credit rating bad, 6%. If we multiply these two probabilities, we see that the actual and predicted classes are both bad with less than 1% just by chance. Here in the bottom row total value, we see the a priori probability of the class good, 90% in our case. Finally, here in the right column total value, we see the predicted probability of the class good, 94%. Again, we multiply these probabilities and see that there is an almost 85% probability of correctly predicting the class good just by random guess. Notice a big difference between the two classes. To get the probability of a correct prediction by chance to any class, PE, we sum up these two probabilities. We use this result and the overall accuracy value to calculate Cohen's Kappa and get 0.279, the same as in the accuracy statistics that we checked before. Now let's go back to our example workflow. This time, in this parallel workflow branch, we try to improve the performance of the decision tree model by resampling the training data. The Cohen's Kappa value is higher for this model, 0.380, than it was for the first model, 0.279. However, the model's better performance is not indicated by the overall accuracy that didn't change at all. Cohen's Kappa is therefore recommended to evaluate the performance of a classification model when the target classes are unbalanced. Cohen's Kappa has a universal range from negative 1 to 1. 1 corresponds to a perfect model. However, be careful when you compare the values of Cohen's Kappa between models, because Cohen's Kappa tends to be higher when the target classes are balanced. Cohen's Kappa is also not informative about the expected prediction accuracy like overall accuracy is. The interpretation of Cohen's Kappa values, even in written terms like moderate, is neither easy nor fixed. In this video, we have introduced Cohen's Kappa statistics to evaluate the performance of a classification model. Cohen's Kappa is a more objective description of the model's performance than overall accuracy, since it takes into account the a priori distribution of the target classes. However, a clear interpretation of Cohen's kappa value can be challenging.